composing and producing, I'm always trying to find out, I think, how much sound I can get out of just one very simple idea. So it's a lot of extractions from this one little melody or loop. Sometimes it comes from an acoustic sound source, like a percussive recording or drums that I'm recording on my own. And very often it's also basic electronic sound sources, like sine waves, noise. And then the extractions of that one simple idea, which is quite basic, is often based on granular sampling, granular synthesis. Sometimes it happens with some specific hardware or something, but often it's also happening inside the computer, so I'm using the computer a lot when I'm producing ideas. And then moving that into a live context, I'm often taking what I've been working on with the computer into various hardware samplers and synthesizers that I'm improvising with. I have a visual approach to both composing and also to sounds in general. So I try to make all the sounds very kind of physical in a way that you can touch every sound in a way. I think I see it a little bit as a drawing or some illustration. Sometimes it comes from an actual drawing or a graphic score that I'm doing and then I'm composing from that, but also when I'm only working with sounds, I guess I try to see it very much as a drawing. Also trying to be quite visual when I'm playing live, I mean, trying to pan things very quickly around and muting things and trying to be very clear about the combination of sound. Very often the samples that I'm producing are coming from something electronic, like some of the electronic equipment that I'm working with, synthesizers and tone generators and simple things. And then I'm processing that with some other but more digital things, also hardware sometimes, but yeah, some of that work also happens in the computer. I'm doing my setup in a little bit different way than I'm used to, so I'm separating things a bit more than I'm normally doing, so specific sounds are going into specific speakers and some sounds are traveling around in circles and then my more or less a main mix is more focused in the middle, so a little bit more mono, I guess, and some specific sound groups of sounds are going into the different types of speakers in the Yakus Mono.